Welcome to the West Wing Week, your weekly wrap-up of this week's second term activities at the White House and beyond. This week, the President honored fallen police officers and top cops, spoke on the implementation of the Affordable Care Act, invited both the Prime Minister of England and of Turkey to the White House, and kicked off a new Google Hangout series on science and technology. That's May 10th through May 16th, or We the Geeks. On Friday, the President spoke in the East Room about the ways the Affordable Care Act is already helping millions of Americans, like the women and families standing behind him, and the need to support it going forward.
In a country as wealthy as this one, there was no reason why a family's security should be determined by the chance of an illness or an accident. We decided to do something about it. And those of us who believe that every American deserves access to quality, affordable health care have an obligation to now make sure that full implementation moves forward the way it needs to.
West Wing Week caught up with Alicia Steinberg, who is also a mother of Avi, a three-year-old leukemia patient.
Thankfully, the Affordable Care Act protects us by ensuring that Avi won't be discriminated against by an insurer based on her pre-existing condition. So it's really given us tremendous peace of mind.
On Saturday, the President honored a group of the nation's best police officers, top cops, who are chosen by the National Association of Police Organizations each year after being nominated by their colleagues for their service and heroism.
We don't always get that opportunity to stand and applaud the men and women who keep us safe, but they're out there. Hundreds of thousands of them, patrolling our streets every single day. And we know that when we need you most, you'll be ready to dash into danger to protect our lives, even if it means putting your lives on the line. That's what the men and women standing behind me have proven, their heart, their courage, their dedication.
On Monday, Prime Minister Cameron arrived from London for a bilateral meeting in the Oval Office and then a press conference where they honored the strength of the alliance between the United States and the United Kingdom. The United Kingdom currently holds the presidency of the G8 and will host the group's next summit in June in Northern Ireland. On Wednesday, the President traveled to the Capitol Building's West Lawn for the National Peace Officers Memorial Service, an annual ceremony honoring law enforcement who were killed in the line of duty in the previous year.
Bobby Kennedy once said that the fight against crime is a fight to preserve that quality of community which is at the root of our greatness. The 143 fallen officers we honor today put themselves on the front lines of that fight to preserve that quality of community and to protect the roots of our greatness. They exemplified the very idea of citizenship, that with our God-given rights come responsibilities and obligations to ourselves and to others. They embodied that idea. That's the way they died. That's how we must remember them, and that's how we must live.
I'm sure he's proud of you, so keep making him proud, all right?
That evening, the President delivered a statement on the situation regarding the Internal Revenue Service after meeting with senior Treasury officials.
I've reviewed the Treasury Department watchdog's report, and the misconduct that it uncovered is inexcusable. It's inexcusable, and Americans are right to be angry about it, and I am angry about it.
On Thursday, the President welcomed Prime Minister Erdogan of Turkey to the White House to discuss issues ranging from economic development to the unfolding conflict in Syria.
Before we get started, let me just make sure that I'm a good host. Ms. Prime Minister, do you want an umbrella? Because we can... there we go. That's good. I'm sorry about it.
Meanwhile, next door in the EOB, the White House kicked off the We the Geeks, a new series of Google Plus Hangouts with administration officials and key private sector contributors that highlight the future of science, technology, and innovation. That afternoon, the President convened a meeting with Secretary Hagel, Chairman Dempsey, and service secretaries, service chiefs, and senior enlisted advisors to discuss continuing efforts to address sexual assault in the military.
This is a priority, and we will not stop until we've seen this scourge from what is the greatest military in the world eliminated.
To find out more information on any of these topics, go to whitehouse.gov and tune in next week when Josh Earnest returns to his regular scheduled post.
I knew you weren't a politician because you weren't too cool.